Welcome to Education. Welcome my dear student. Today we go for the second experiment, that is your reciprocating pump. So first of all, aim of the experiment to determine the efficiency of a reciprocating pump and the apparatus required, reciprocating pump test rig, stopwatch and another steel rule. So about the theory part, the hydraulic machine which convert the mechanical energy into hydraulic energy is called the pump, and hydraulic energy is in the form of pressure energy. So reciprocating pump is a positive displacement pump in which the liquid is sucked and then it is pushed due to the thrust exerted by on its moving member, which result in lifting the liquid to the required height. So reciprocating pump can be classified according to the movement of the piston, that is single acting, double acting, like this. So single acting pump is the liquid in which in contact with one side of the piston, that means the liquid level in one side. But in case of double acting pump, the same is in contact with the both side of the piston. We move for the machine part. About the machine part, this arrangement is your reciprocating pump test rig. Here one cylinder and piston arrangement, inside it this is the motor, and from the motor power will transmit through this step down pulley and belt drive. That's why what happen when this pulley is rotated, another cam and follower arrangement inside it. That's why the piston moves from TDC to BDC. TDC stands for top dead center to bottom dead center. BDC, bottom dead center to top dead center. Similar way, what happen when the piston moves from TDC to BDC and BDC to DC, at that time vacuum is created in DC end. That's why it will lift the water through the suction pipe and deliver it towards the delivery pipe. So another fusible plug. Here another fusible plug, if the pressure is more, then automatically it will lift up, which save for your accident. Then this is the outlet valve and this is the outlet tank. Then from the shaft it was connected, from the outlet tank this is the connection of the towards sump. Next we move for the controlling part. So this is your total arrangement. This part is the energy meter, this is the outlet suction head and this is the delivery head. So suction pressure and delivery pressure, and this is the power supply unit switch up. When we switching up, automatically power will supply from the energy meter to motor. Similar way, to move for the governing formula. For finding out the efficiency, basic two things are necessary: output or input. So for output formula, WQS, W is the specific weight of the water, Q is the discharge, that is the actual rate of flow of the fluid particle in outlet tank. That's formula is your A into S by T. So area of the outlet tank, T is the time for maintaining the height, and H is the height of the water level in outlet tank. Similar way, H is the total head. Total head means it is the suction, addition of the suction head and delivery head. Similar way, formula for input, X by T into 3600 into 1 by C. So C is the energy meter constant, that is 3200 impulse per kilowatt hour, and X is the number of blinking LED, 5 blinking. So for T is the time for 5 blinking, time required for 5 blinking, that is your T, X is the number of blinking. Next, so before starting the experiment, first we close the gauges part.
This is the suction pressure and this is the delivery pressure. And always remind, the outlet valve should be open. Otherwise, if it is closed, then it may create another accident. Due to always this reciprocating pump is a positive displacement pump. So first of all, we open it. Next, and we close these two. Next, we move for the switching. After running 10 to 5 minutes to maintain a constant, after that blinking also here, slowly open this pressure valve. Here also suction pressure. And slowly we close the outlet. Now just mark here, this is the delivery pressure and this is the suction pressure. So here the suction pressure is 120 and delivery pressure is the 0.1. Okay. And the unit is mm per hg in suction and the in delivery kg per centimeter square. After that we convert it into head. Similar way, now we take the for 5 blinkings how much time will be taken, we measure by the stopwatch. Now for 5 blinkings it is 18.2 seconds. Similar way, we close the outlet part and here also another measuring tube for 5 centimeter height. So that is 6 seconds for 5 centimeter height, time will be 6 seconds, then immediately you open the outlet. So after that, similar way, you take 5 readings. Next, you go for the tabulation part. So after this experiment, these are the collecting data from our experiment. So area of the outlet tank 900 centimeter square, similar way suction pressure, delivery pressure, total head, time for 5 centimeter height in outlet tank and time for 5 blinkings. So these are the calculation parts. Already we find out that the suction pressure and delivery pressure, and we put the value by this equations to convert the suction head and delivery head. Then we find out the input and output and the efficiency. So similar way for 4 observation, these are the efficiencies, and finally we find out the mean efficiency. And finally the conclusion part, we determine the efficiency of a reciprocating pump and its efficiency is this. Thank you.